Yo, what is good, YouTube, and welcome back to another JC2K video. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at all of the brand new Rush 3 players coming today here in NBA 2K24 MyTEAM, talking about which ones are worth grinding for, which ones you should maybe stay away from, and how good overall this drop is in MyTEAM. Before we hop into the video, if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Help me push towards the 25,000 subscriber mark on the channel I upload every single day. Tons of consistent daily MyTEAM content. Would really appreciate it if y'all do subscribe. Without further ado, let's hop right in. Let's start with the Amethysts, and let's break this set down. So Michael Carter was first Amethyst, a 6'5 PG, not probably a terrible card for an Amethyst whatsoever. 92 speed and excel, 85 three ball, 85 driving dunk, defensively pretty good looking, missing some shooting badges, doesn't have agent three blinders or limitless rage at all, but like pretty darn good playmaking badges, defensively not terrible either. This card, I mean, for a 6'5 PG, he's not awful. I don't know how his release is, but Kyrie dribble style is really nice. Braun Escape isn't great. Rest of six don't look too awesome. So I don't know. But if his release is pretty good, Kyrie dribble style as well gives you a really nice go-to. Like, I don't know if I want to say go-to sig, but it kind of is. That dribble style is kind of a little bit of a cheat code almost. So just makes dribbling a lot easier, I feel like, when you have that. So in general, I think the Michael Carter Williams card is actually going to be pretty good. Like, I don't know if he's insane, but he's not a terrible point guard option for an Amethyst. He's just obviously not a top-tier PG either. Roni Sikali, I don't actually know how to pronounce his name, but 6'11 with a 7'2 wingspan at the center spot. Not insanely fast. He's not horribly slow, but 73 ball isn't great either by any means. And he's not a ball handler at all. He's an interior card on both ends of the court. He has half anchor, half back down punisher, half masher, bunch of inside badges on both ends of the court. That's about it. In all honesty, this card is too limited. I think, honestly, as a shooter, especially with Brook Lopez base, this card sucks. He's terrible. Because that Lopez base stinks too. Yeah, no, this card is not good. Definitely would not recommend running Sikali. Tyreke Evans, he's a 6'6 PG. This card's actually probably pretty good. 95 speed excel, 88 three ball, 85 driving dunk, defensively pretty good. Great playmaking and finishing badges. Shooting badges, he does have half limitless, does not have agent three or blinders, but at all. But he's got, I mean, gold limitless, so that's good. Gold defensive badges on the perimeter as well. I mean, if you badge him out, he's a stud. Otherwise, he's probably not incredible. But Evan 40, his release is pretty good. Lillard dribble style, Braun Escape isn't like the most insane sigs or anything, but he does have a good behind the back and jaw wall drag back. So that is nice. I mean, overall, not a bad looking card. For a diamond PG, he does look pretty good. I think he's going to be a good option. Maybe wish he had a couple of half defensive badges. Maybe was a little more well-rounded defensively, but the slashing and finishing will be elite, and then the shooting and defense should both be very capable as well. I think he'll be a good card. Tony Allen, probably not a very good card, because the thing about Tony Allen is, well, I guess he does have 95 speed, 95 driving dunk, and amazing, amazing defense. So they did kind of soup him up a little bit, but he's definitely still not the most complete, especially he's just so limited as a shooter. His release isn't good either. At the two, that is a huge, huge liability. That lack of size and lack of shooting ability is a real big issue. So, yes, he's a super great, really good athlete, and he's an incredible defender. But that in and of itself is not enough to justify a card having a spot on a team. I don't think this Tony Allen card honestly looks all that good at all. Okay, Chandler Parsons, Allen Iverson, Danny Granger are the three cards we have left to review. In all honesty, I'm not going to sit here and say I'm like insanely excited about any of these guys either. Specifically, like Chandler Parsons, here's the thing. Probably doesn't play enough defense. Well, defensively, he's better than I thought. Needs anchor, needs brick wall. Doesn't have clamps on Hoff, but he has Hoff Interceptor, Hoff Bump, has Pogo Stick. Hoff Bulldozer, Fast Twitch, bunch of shooting badges, gold finishing badges. Playmaking badges are okay, I guess, but no speed booster. Yeah, he needs some badges added. His release, I do know, is pretty nice, even though they only have it on normal timing still. I'm so not a fan of Pink Diamonds not getting animation changes. I'm not surprised by it, but I definitely don't like it. And so, like, I think Chandler Parsons, while he's not a bad small forward option, he's going to need a couple badges added. There's already a bunch of good small forwards. I don't sit here and look at this card and see anything particularly special about him. He's not bad. But the thing to remember is, like, last week we also got a free small forward in James Worthy. There's a bunch of other good small forwards options. So, guys, like, Granger is free today, but also Chandler Parsons, like, we don't need that many small forwards. And Granger is probably a better option. So, in general, Chandler Parsons, he doesn't look awful. I know his release is pretty good, but I think he'll likely be not that great of a card. AI is only 6 foot, so he's small. And that in of itself isn't really going to cut it. His stats obviously are incredible. 98 speed, excel, 98 three ball, 95 driving dunk, defensively really good as well. And he's super fast, great ball handler, all that type of stuff. Badge wise, he's got Posterizer, Whistle, Agent 3, Blinders, Limitless, bunch of playmaking badges, 94 feet, Clamps, Glove. Good looking card. Has Gold Anchor. The thing is, even with great, great stats, great, great badges, which he does have, he is too small at 6 foot to really be great, especially with his release only on normal and still all of his SIGs as base SIGs. He's just not good enough all the way around to be an elite level PG, I don't think. I think offensively he'll be able to hold it down, but I do think defensively, even with good defensive stats and badges, it's just unlikely he's going to be that great of a defensive card. Not unlikely, it's impossible. He's only 6 foot tall, he's too small, so it kind of is what it is. AI is not going to be great. He'll be kind of fun to use, but he certainly won't be an awesome card. And then Danny Granger is the top tier card. I'm sure he's good, but like, I don't know if he's incredible. 6'9 with a 7'1 wingspan is pretty good size. Hotspots for everywhere. 26 obstacles, bulldozer, posterizer, precision dunker, bajillion shooting badges. And then some good playmaking as well. Defensively, could use a little bit of work. Challenger, interceptor, off ball pest, on Hoff. He needs anchor and brick wall added. Has gold badges defensively. I mean, he could be a little better defensively, but the stats are good. 85 driving dunk, very good finishing badges, and then shooting wise, absolutely phenomenal. Release is Haywood High. It's the same jump shot he already had, but it's on very quick now, so that does definitely help. D-book dribble style is a positive. CP escape. Outside of that, the rest of his SIGs don't look like anything special, but at least he's got a good dribble style and a good escape. And overall, I mean, he's a good card. He doesn't look unbelievable. I think Worthy looks better, realistically, especially on the defensive end of the court. But he's not bad. This isn't as good of a rush set, in all honesty, as the last couple of weeks have been. Like, Austin Reeves and Jaren Jackson Jr., that was an amazing set. Last week's set was even better, with James Worthy, Michael Cooper, Victor Oladipo, even Diamond Fultz. Like, there were a lot of good cards in these drops this last couple of weeks. And, like, this isn't the worst drop in the world. I guess in Michael Carter-Williams and Tyreek are interesting. Chandler Parsons will be okay. Would be fun if not great, and then Granger's like good but not insane because of his lack of defense. I think it's a fine drop. I don't think it's anything special whatsoever. That being said, I apologize if y'all can hear in my voice the congestion and stuff. I am sick. I am definitely sick. I cannot breathe through my nose like at all. So we're going to do the best we can to push out as much content, as many videos as possible today, but I certainly am not feeling great. So bear with me, and I apologize if my voice is a little bit harder to understand than normal because I certainly am not feeling well today. But that is okay, and as they say, the show must go on, right? So here we are, ready to get to work and hopefully get a bunch of gameplays out with these domination cards as well as with these rush cards over the next couple of days. But yeah, I'll be dropping a video, obviously, just a little bit talking about how to get each of these cards individually, and the fastest and easiest way to get these cards in your collection. And yeah, that is going to do it for this video. So I hope y'all did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. I'll be back with more 2K content very, very soon, and I appreciate y'all. Peace.